In case this is the first time you're seeing me, my name is Lakpo Shueto and I'm a love coach. So what this means is that I help single women attract love, I help them find the right men for them, and I help them build their confidence. So today, I'm going to be talking about something that a lot of women have asked me for help about. And it's really very strange that so many people are going through a particular thing, but you won't know about it unless you ask. And in fact, some of these things that people are going through, they won't even occur to you. Well, this particular topic did occur to me, in that I didn't think that so many people were going through it until I got that information. And so because I know that so many women who are my clients tend to be women who are single and over 30. So many of them are going through this particular issue, and I knew I had to treat the topic with a video. So today's topic is how to get over the fear of heartbreak. This is a really big issue for many women. They're so scared of getting their heart broken that they don't go into relationships. They second guess themselves all the time, and they worry that their heart will be broken and it will be the same thing all over again. At the same time, they want to get into relationships, they want to get married, and they want to be happy. They know that this fear of getting their heart broken is stopping them from getting what it is that they want. So they want to know how to overcome that fear. And that's where I come in. That's where I'm going to help with this video. Okay, so the first thing I want to say is, to help you get over your fear of being heartbroken, you need to remember that it happens to everybody. There's nobody that hasn't had their heart broken before, whether they are beautiful or ugly or incredibly rich. Everyone has had their heart broken before. So it's not just you. It's not because you're fat or you're skinny or you're flat-chested or you're so tall that you keep getting your heart broken. It's not about that. It happens to every single person. You need to take comfort in that. Now, if you want to get over your fear of getting your heart broken, another thing you need to do is to ask yourself, what's the worst that could happen? If you get your heart broken again, what is the worst that could happen? Fine, you know that it means that you will be in such pain. You know, heartbreak is this horrible way. Sometimes it feels quite physical. It feels very real. It feels like your heart is tearing. Sometimes it feels as if there's something wrapped around it and it's just crushing it. Sometimes the pain feels very real. Is that the worst that could happen? Imagine what it is. When you imagine what it is, you know that you can get over that thing. Start putting things in place to get over it. Sometimes when it comes to heartbreak, mixed with the emotional and physical pain, some people are really scared about their financial situation. So they relied on this partner for their finances, and then when the breakup comes, they're thinking, oh my God, how am I going to cope financially? So imagine the worst that could happen. If it's that you would be in financial trouble, start working towards keeping yourself financially happy, financially stable. Work towards that. If the worst that could happen is that you'll be emotional pain, start thinking about how you can deal with that, and realizing that other people have gone through this and they've come out on top. They've come out better despite the pain that they've gone through. So the second tip is to ask yourself, what's the worst thing that could happen? My third tip for how to get over heartbreak, and I think this is actually the best tip, it is to focus on positive possibilities. You know, think about the future. Think about how beautiful your life will be when you are in the right relationship, when you are happy with the person that you are with. Think about the possibilities that can come to you. Think about how happy you can be when you're getting married, if marriage is what you want. Think about how happy you'll be if you have children with a partner that you love. Think about all these amazing possibilities. Think about how you could go on holiday with your partner, how you could work with your partner and build an empire, a big business. Think about all the lovely things that could happen simply because you are in the right relationship. That kind of imagination, the positive things that could happen to you as a result of being in the right relationship, can motivate you. It can give you the strength to know that heartbreak is not permanent and that you should get over it and that you can get over it. So don't focus on the physical pain or the emotional pain. Don't focus on all the bad things that have happened because of heartbreak. Don't focus on the things that have happened in the past. Don't focus on how many times your heart has been broken before. Focus on the future. Focus on what can be. That will help you get over your fear of heartbreak. Now, if you're going through heartbreak and you want someone to help you get over that, you want someone to help you heal your heart, you want someone that will help you learn to love again, if you want to learn how to turn your heartbreak into happiness, then I'm the person for you. Like I said, I'm a love coach and I can help you turn heartbreak into happiness. And right now I can do that with you via WhatsApp coaching. Yes, it's true. I now offer WhatsApp coaching. So if you want one-on-one attention from me via WhatsApp, or you want one-on-one coaching from me via WhatsApp, then you need to try my WhatsApp coaching. For more details about it, go to www.lapesoetan.com/coaching. That's www.lapesoetan.com/coaching. There you'll see all the details about my WhatsApp coaching, how much it costs, what it involves, and what you can gain out of it. I hope you will check it out, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Please share it with your friends and give it a like below, and I'll see you again next time. Thank you for joining me. Bye.